Okay, my camera cut me off again, my device. Okay, so I was saying that the background here is paper. She can write whatever she wants to write on there. If she wants to put a note or whatever, she can. She doesn't have to. Or she can use these tags as gifts and give them away, use them for a gift tag or something. But anyway, that's that page. And then the last page has, see, I used the checkerboard as a background, the paper or the fabric, and then I ended up covering it all. I wanted bits and pieces to show, but I ended up covering it. This is another this is another paper tag. I left it blank so she can write whatever she wants. It's got a piece of lace that I just wrapped around and punched the hole, and then that acts as a reinforcer. This is a hand crocheted little chain and another garment pin with a little gold cross. Just because I love crosses and I wanted to send, since this is a Renaissance book, I wanted to send a little bit of faith here. I think this was a lace that I got from TPG Crafts. These are just little flower bits and little doily bits. I've got sentimental and bling there, and on the background I have like a little bit of a wedding dress. And this was stamped. No, this was printed a long time ago. I have a bunch of these. I think they're all old, like picture studio, logos, from when you go and get your photographs professionally done. That's what they are. They're picture studio logos. And I just put some glitter, a little bit of glitter around the frame. And that's the pocket there. And then we're to the back, and that's my book. That's it. It's all done. I have lots of little blingy stuff everywhere. So again, I'm just gonna do close-up pictures of everything. You can look and see how cute this came out. I think it came out really pretty. I'm really happy how it came out, and I definitely am going to make some more of these books in this style. I loved sewing, and you've got to kind of think about what you're doing when you do this, because when you do one side and you're sewing all this stuff on and you have a pocket on this side, you've got to like remember not, anyway, you got to remember that there's going to be a pocket, and you've got to like seriously plan stuff out, because if you sew back here, then you might sew into your picture. You know what I mean? Or as you're sewing your picture, you might sew back here. So yeah, it takes some planning for sure. Let's go here. Yep, and I did show that one, did I? Well, let's show that one again. That's my favorite. I love the purple. Ah, it's so beautiful. Okay, there's that one with the bead. And there's that one. And those two. and the front. And then it's really chunky, so what I do is I just put the bead inside. And then the button is sewn on really well, so you just gotta, like, you know, push it down a little bit. And then just wrap the button, wrap the loop around the button. And I definitely will need to, since this was my first one, in hindsight, and improvements would be make the front page a little bit longer and the back page. Because once you start filling up the pages, your front page, you know, with all the stuff, it starts scooching back. So I definitely will remember that in the next book to make my covers at least an inch or half an inch wider on the front and the back, so that by the time you fill everything or fill your book, then your pages in the front are going to cover, you know. And I did that with my Gone with the Wind book. I don't know why I didn't think about doing that with this book. But as I said, well, this book I started a long time ago, so I probably didn't know about that. And I'm just now finishing it. So this book has been probably a good 6 months in the making, in between projects. So I'm glad I finally finished this one, and I have some other projects that I'm going to show you that I finally finished also. So I hope you like it. That's my pretty little book. And if anyone would like me to make them a book, I do commission work. I do create journals and fabric books via commissions. And so just let me know. Anyway, this will be a gift, or not, this will be mailed off to its owner. I should have mailed it today, but I have to mail it tomorrow because I wasn't quite done yet. So, but anyway, this will be mailed off to its new owner, and I hope that she loves it just as much as I loved making it for her, or finishing it for her. Anyway, thanks everyone for stopping by. Sorry, I've been MIA for the longest time. I know. I'm just trying to get some stuff done. I have, like I say, I've got 4 fabric books that I am working on right now that I've been working on for the last 6 months. I really need to get them done and move on. I want to do other things, and I can't do other things until I finish those. I also have my banner that I'm going to make for my granddaughter sitting on hold. I haven't forgotten. I just haven't gotten the time. So there's lots and lots of projects coming. Hang out with me. I know I, oops, I just bumped you guys. I'm sorry. I also need to start on my friend's book with all of the beautiful pages that everyone sent me for my challenge. I haven't even started that one yet. So I know I'm behind, but I just want to get these few projects done, and then I can move on. Because I have too many unfinished things. When I do a project, let me move this over just a little bit. I have little boxes like this. This was the project book. Well, not this, because I just recently dyed these, and I have a video showing. I'm going to share these in the next video. But these are, you know, fabrics that I use. There's that fabric. The checkerboard fabric. These are the fabrics I used for this book. And, you know, these are, some of these are from Linda Green, which I didn't mention because I ended up covering some of her fabrics that I used. I think I only used this one and the black. And no, I used this one and the black, but then I ended up covering it. Anyway, so I have a bunch of these little boxes that I made with my wallpaper. With my fancy wallpapers. These are my task boxes. So when I'm working on a project, everything goes in that box. And then when I switch gears, I move this to the side and I bring my next box. And then my desk is covered with all kinds of stuff. So anyway, that's how I do it. Yeah, that's it. That's it, everyone. I hope you like my book. I think it came out really pretty. And I will be showing some more projects next up. So stay tuned. Bye, everyone. God bless. Thanks for all your comments, all your kindness, all your personal messages. Thank you, everyone who has purchased from my store. I'm way behind in my store as well. Oh, there's just not enough time in the day. And yeah, I think Janine, I love your little flowers. I have them here with my other pin cushions. I've got your little birdie here as well. And I am using your flower for a little let me stick the little birdie there for a pin cushion. I just love that flower. That's my favorite one, the green one. So, yeah. Anyway, thanks everyone for stopping by. And God bless everyone. Stay tuned for more projects. Bye.